there, I knew what to do. I knew exactly where I was trying to aim it. I just came straight right off the face. I didn't have the right kind of swing to put on it. Like, I know what to do to set up the shot. I didn't pull the shot off that I wanted to. It went straight right into the trees, and I lost about 100 yards of distance. But I have 190 to the pin, to the back. I'm in the rough, so I'm gonna hit a 5-iron, because it'll release out of this. Especially with a 5-iron, it usually draws out of this kind of lie. That should land just short of the green, or just on, and release all the way up to the back. Dead is long. Oh, I hit that flush. Settle. I can't see it because half the green is covered by, oh yep, there it is, it rolled into the sun. It's on the green, I just don't know how far it is. It's kind of hard to tell from 190 out. I get a lot of holes like this. Blocked my drive right into the trees. As you can see, the tee box was back there, I had to slice it. Blocked my second shot straight right in the trees. I had 190 out, and somehow I'm still 15 feet from birdie. Also on a 605 yard par 5. Way too hard. Still have a long putt for par. It's not the birdie that I was looking for after being that close after my third shot, but hell, I take a par after not hitting the fairway at all on the hole. I take a par anyways if I did hit the fairway on a 605 yard par 5. So I still remain 200 through 4 holes. This next hole is the last hole of the tough stretch. So I got 208 here. It's usually 217, which would be a perfect 5-wood, but the pin's at the front, so I have to choke down. It wouldn't be a perfect 5-wood if the pin was in the middle. It would just be like a regular choke down. But 208, I kind of have to choke down a little bit more, almost to the shaft, and hopefully get it on the green. And now this is the last par 3 where I need to use a 5-wood. Well, that's gone really high off the face. Get up. Yeah, wow.
The car's come up 20 yards short here. He, for one calculation he failed to figure was that he was into the breeze and the 5-wood just spoons up. Oh, it can't be short to get that ball at least past the hole. So Carl's left himself a bit more than he should have with what was a relatively easy chip there.
I think I just overthought my first shot, and I forgot that I forgot to allow for the conditions. So 206, that would be just a, it wouldn't be a full 5-wood, but it would be a choke down. Not as much as I did. I was down here. I should have been like there. But I would take par there. I was even through the tough 3-hole stretch. Now I have a 2 par 5s, a par 3, and a par 4 to close.